Welcome students for the third lecture of BSc 2. Last time we have seen the general terms that are often used in the study of electrochemistry. Your first chapter, it is the electrolytic conductivity, and we have discussed what is conductance. Then what are the different types of conductors you have studied? There are two types of conductors, metallic conductor and electrolytic conductor. Then the distinguishing points in between these two conductors. Then the definitions of the terms conductance, resistance, specific resistance, then specific conductance, equivalent conductance and molar conductance. And for this lecture you will learn the variation of conductance with dilution. Here once again I will explain you what is the specific conductance, what is the equivalent conductance and what is the molar conductance, and how these three conductances they varies with the dilution. Variation of conductance with dilution or concentration. And you know, dilution means decrease in concentration. Before going to see how the specific conductance, equivalent conductance and molar conductance, it varies with dilution, I will explain you at first the what is specific conductance, what is equivalent conductance and molar conductance. At first, last time you have studied the conductance is the property of conductor, either that conductor is metallic or electrolytic, which facilitates the flow of electricity through it, and it is the reciprocal of resistance. That is, conductance, it is equal to 1 by resistance and it is equal to 1 by R, and the unit of conductance is ohm inverse. And remember well, conductance, it depends on number of ions present in the solution. Then here already I have told you the property of conductor, which facilitates the flow of electricity through it, it is called as conductance. And we have three different conductances as specific conductance. Here the specific conductance is nothing but the conductance of a solution of a definite dilution enclosed in a cell having two electrodes of unit area separated by centimeter apart, 1 centimeter apart. Or the specific conductance is the conductance of 1 cc solution, where cc means centimeter cube solution. The conductance of 1 centimeter cube solution, it is also called as specific conductance. Then another type of conductance, it is the equivalent conductance, and equivalent conductance is the conductance of all the ions produced by 1 gram equivalent of electrolyte in a given solution. And the third type of conductance, it is the molar conductance, and molar conductance is the conductance of all the ions produced by ionization of 1 gram mole of electrolyte when present in phi mls of a solution. These are the three different types of conductance. Then Here, to explain the specific conductance, mathematically we can write a resistance. It is proportional to length and inversely proportional to cross-sectional area A. Remember, the resistance offered by any conductor for the passage of electricity, it is directly proportional to length of the conductor and inversely proportional to area of cross-section. This is the one of the important equation. And therefore, we can write R, it is equal to rho into L by A, where rho, it is the proportionality constant and it is called as specific resistance. When L equal to 1 centimeter and this A, area of cross section, it is equal to 1 centimeter square, under this condition, the resistance of the solution, it becomes equal to specific resistance. Thus, we define the specific resistance as the resistance of 1 centimeter cube of a conductor. And the reciprocal of specific resistance is termed as the specific conductance, or it is also termed as this, it is denoted by a symbol kappa. This is the Greek letter kappa. Here, this equation, it is explained in this highlight box. The resistance of any conductor varies directly as a length L and inversely proportional to its cross-sectional area. Therefore, the specific conductance, mathematically, it is written as 1 by rho. That means a reciprocal of specific resistance is the specific conductance, where this kappa, it is the Greek letter. And again, we can write rho, it is equal to A into R by L. That means specific conductance, it is equal to conductance into cell constant. Mathematically, we can write this equation. Last time we have seen in a detail. So here remember that specific conductance, it is the product of conductance and cell constant, and the 1 by rho means specific conductance, and it is inversed, then we get L by A. Therefore, this ratio L by A, it is the cell constant, and 1 by R, it is the conductance. Therefore, specific conductance, it is equal to conductance multiplied by cell constant. In the case of electrolytic solutions, the specific conductance is defined as conductance of a solution of definite dilution enclosed in a cell having two electrodes of unit area separated by 1 centimeter apart with the unit of specific conductance. Then, in a brief regarding the units of molar conductance, specific conductance and equivalent conductance. Here, as all of you know, the unit of conductance, it is ohm inverse, and molar conductance, it is expressed in the units of ohm inverse into centimeter raised to minus 2 into mole raised to minus 1. That means moves per centimeter square per mole, it is the unit of molar conductance. Then the specific conductance has the unit ohm inverse into centimeter inverse, or ohm inverse, it is also equal to moves. Therefore, the conductance, specific conductance unit, is moles into centimeter inverse, and SI unit here Siemen into meter inverse. Then the equivalent conductance is expressed in the units of ohm inverse into centimeter raised to minus 2 into equivalent raised to minus 1. That means moles per centimeter square per equivalent. These are the units of molar conductance, specific conductance and equivalent conductance. Then the next point, measurement of conductance. How the conductance is measured? Nowadays there is a direct instrument for the measurement of conductance. That means we have a conductivity cell, and the construction of conductivity cell, it is nothing but the two platinum electrodes having cross-sectional area 1 centimeter square, and the area distance between these two electrodes, it is equal to 1 centimeter. Such a two electrodes are sealed in a glass vessel, and for electrical contact there is a wires. This is the construction of conductivity cell. This conductivity cell, when dipped in a solution whose conductance is to be measured, it is connected with the conductometer, and conductometer, it is the instrument which measures the conductance reading directly. But before that, I am going to explain you the measurement of conductance with the help of Wheatstone bridge. Here in the Wheatstone bridge, the resistance of the solution is at first measured, and by taking the reciprocal we can determine the conductance. And for this purpose, we take one Wheatstone bridge, then a conductivity solution and conductivity cell. That cell is connected to the Wheatstone bridge. Here the resistance of solution between two parallel electrodes is determined by using Wheatstone bridge method. The Wheatstone, it is name of the scientist who investigated this method. Then the diagram of the apparatus is shown in the next slide. I will explain you. Then C is the conductivity cell containing the solution of the electrolyte, and S represents the source of the alternating current, and R is the resistance box, and T is the headphone. To detect the flow of current, a suitable resistance is taken out from the resistance box, and the sliding contact X is moved on the AB wire to stretch a point of minimum sound in the headphone. At this point, the bridge is under the balanced condition, and under the balanced condition, we have equation as resistance of solution divided by resistance of the resistance box, it is equal to resistance of the wire XB divided by resistance of the wire XA. That means it is equal to the length XB divided by length XA. Thus, the resistance of solution can be used for to produce the complications. The schematic representation of the measurement of resistance with the help of Wheatstone bridge. This Wheatstone bridge, it is nothing but it consists of a metallic wire. Here this AB, it is a metallic wire having uniform thickness and uniform, and it is stretched stout in between these two points, point A and point B, and this is a headphone. Then here it is a resistance box. It is connected in between these two points, and one point it is connected to the source, and here this B point it is connected to the source again. That means in between the metal wire we have a source, and this source we have used here, it is the induction coil. Induction coil, it consists of primary and secondary, and here is the battery. Then in this solution, here it is a thermostat which keeps the temperature constant of our solution under study, and we have dipped a conductivity cell into this solution. This is our test solution, and above this we have thermostat. And when we measure the conductance of this test solution, what we have to do? We have to remove a certain known resistance from this resistance box, and this sliding contact X, it is moved on the uniform wire AB to have a minimum sound in this headphone here. And suppose X, at this X point we have minimum sound in the headphone, then this is the condition of balanced bridge. At this time we can say that the resistance of the box divided by resistance of the solution, it is equal to the resistance of this length XB divided by resistance of this length XA. And thus, by measuring the resistance, we can calculate the resistance of this solution, and by taking the reciprocal, we can determine the conductance of the solution. And this is the determination of conductance by using Wheatstone bridge method. Due to light problem, the slideshow is not beginning. So we will wait for some time. Okay. Yes. Then the circuit diagram of the Wheatstone bridge, it is shown in this diagram. Here, this is our A point. Here, it is our B point. And in between this, we have this one is the R1 resistance. It is a known resistance. Here, it is R2 resistance. Then, here, it is variable resistance. And here, we have R4, it is a unknown resistance. Then by removing certain resistance from this R3. Under the balanced condition of bridge, we can write R1 divided by R2, it is equal to R3 by R4. This R4, it is our unknown resistance, and we can calculate this. Then in between this A and B, we have, this is the battery. This is the circuit diagram of direct reading conductance bridge. Then the whole credit of the Wheatstone bridge method, it goes to Sir Charles Wheatstone. And the Charles Wheatstone, he is an English physicist. One of the best contribution by him to the science came in the form of Wheatstone bridge. His father was a music seller, because of which Wheatstone was also attracted towards music and poetry. He worked with many musical instruments and improved them, and invented some great instruments also. Other than Wheatstone bridge, he also worked on velocity of electricity, spectroscopy, telegraph, cryptography, electrical generators, and optics. And he died on 19 October 1875 in Paris due to inflammation of lungs. Due to his great contribution towards the measurement of conductance, we have too much benefited. Then, change in concentration of the solution occurs due to electrolysis, which will change the resistance. Again, if the polarization takes place at the electrodes, then also the resistance of the solution varies or changes. That's why an alternating current, that means AC, is used to overcome the above complications. Here, the solution whose conductance is to be measured is taken in a special type of cell, and that cell is known as conductivity cell. The electrode consists of platinum disc coated with finely divided platinum black and welded to platinum wires fused into glass tubes. The glass tubes contain mercury and finely fixed in the cover of cells. Contact with the platinum is made by dipping the copper wires of the circuit in the mercury contained in the tube. This is the construction of conductivity cell. As the conductivity changes with temperature, the cell is usually placed in a constant temperature bath during the experiment. So we have kept our conductivity measurement beaker in the thermostat, and the cells along with paths are used for concentrated solution, and cells with short path and large electrodes are used for dilute solution. Depending on the conductance, whether it is high, whether it is low, or whether it is medium, we may use the different types of conductivity cells. We see later on the different types of conductivity cells. Then this is the schematic representation or experimental setup, how we measure the conductance directly. This is the instrument which measures directly the conductance of the solution. Here is a stand, and here is a conductor. This one is the conductor cell, and in this beaker we have taken a solution whose conductance is to be determined. And this conductivity cell, it is properly dipped into the solution, and by some standardization And when we on this instrument, directly we measure the conductance of the solution. In our laboratory, there are 5 conductometers. With the help of these conductometers, we measure the conductance of different solutions. At the time of practical, I will explain you how the standardization of conductometer is performed. Time being, simply remember the setup, how to measure the conductance of solution. Okay, then next point regarding the cell constant. Here already mathematically the cell constant, it is equal to the ratio of L divided by A, where L, it is the length in between the two electrodes, and A, it is the cross-sectional area. In every time, it is not possible to measure the length in between the two electrodes and area of cross-section. So, the cell constant, it is determined by another method, and it is explained here. For the determination of cell constant, except measuring directly L and A, the solution, standard solution of KCl is taken, its conductance is measured, and the specific conductance divided by conductance of the solution of standard solution, this ratio, it gives cell constant. This is one of the peculiar method in the determination of cell constant. This will also, I will explain you at the time of practicals. Then, the next point. Here, the next point, effect of dilution on equivalent conductance, molar conductance, and specific conductance. Already, you know, the dilution means decrease in concentration. And what happens when we dilute the solution or decrease the concentration with the conductance of the solution, specific conductance of the solution, and equivalent conductance of the solution? Remember that conductance of solution, it totally depends on the number of ions present in the solution. According to definition, the specific conductance of the solution, it is the conductance of 1 cc solution. Therefore, on dilution, the number of ions per cc solution, it decreases. Though on dilution, degree of dissociation increases, the number of ions per cc decreases. Therefore, on dilution, the specific conductance decreases. Remember well, on dilution, specific conductance decreases due to decrease in number of ions per cc. Remember, though on dilution, degree of dissociation increases, but the extent of dissociation is less one. And due to this, the number of ions per cc, it decreases. So, the specific conductance on dilution decreases. Then, in this diagram, I have shown you the equivalent conductance, how it varies with concentration. This diagram clearly shows that at dilute solutions, the conductance is maximum, and as concentration, here as dilution increases, conductance also decreases. Okay, here the value of equivalent conductance increases with dilution, and this is due to, by the definition of equivalent conductance, equivalent conductance, it is the product of specific conductance into volume of the solution. Here on dilution, the volume of the solution it increases. Though specific conductance decreases, the extent of dilution is greater. Therefore, equivalent conductance with dilution it increases. And this diagram it shows here. This is the graph for acetic acid. As dilution is less or concentration is less, the equivalent conductance it increases, and it has no any limiting value. By the graph of equivalent conductance versus concentration, for example, in case of potassium chloride, barium chloride and nickel sulfate, it has a certain limiting value, and this limiting value it is termed as equivalent conductance at infinite dilution. So with the help of this graph, we can recognize or we can differentiate in between strong electrolytes and weak electrolytes. In case of weak electrolytes, there is no any limiting value of equivalent conductance. Equivalent conductance of weak electrolyte, it goes on increasing and increasing with dilution, that means at a low concentration. And in case of strong electrolytes, equivalent conductance it has a certain limiting value, and this limiting value it is called as equivalent conductance at infinite dilution. Remember, similarly on dilution, molar conductance also increases. Then here I will read this. The one which has a relatively small number of ions is called weak electrolyte. The number of ions from an electrolyte depends on degree of dissociation. The curve shows variation of equivalent conductance of some electrolytes with dilution. It shows that electrolytes behave in two ways on dilution. Thus, it is concluded that the equivalent conductance of electrolytes, whether strong electrolyte or weak electrolyte, increases with dilution, reaches to a maximum or limiting value, which is determined or which is termed as lambda infinity. Equivalent conductance at infinite dilution, lambda infinity, in the case of strong electrolytes, cannot be obtained by extrapolation of the graph of equivalent conductance to zero concentration. But in case of weak electrolytes, it cannot be obtained accurately. An indirect method for obtaining lambda infinity for weak electrolyte, it has given by the Korlash law. This is the name of scientist. With the help of Korlash law, we can determine the equivalent conductance at infinite dilution of the weak electrolytes by using the Korlash law. We see later on. Thank you very much.